Jimmy Wales, I want to know, how do you explain the point, and how do you feel about it, that so that Bill Gates, the founders of Google and others, have become fantastically rich on their internet success, and other huge contributors, including you, I think of Tim Berners-Lee, Richard Stallman, have not. And I also am wondering, what would Ayn Rand make of it? I think of her as being an avid individualist and capitalist, but what do you make of it?
Yeah, not much. I mean, it is interesting, and it is one of the questions that comes up quite often. People say, oh, you're an objectivist, how come you're not milking this for every last cent? And I think that's really a misunderstanding of what objectivism is about. If you think back, if you're familiar with the Fountainhead, right? And you remember Howard Roark, who went and worked in a quarry rather than compromise his principles on what he was trying to accomplish artistically and creatively with his work, when he could have made tons of money as a famous architect, that, you know, you realize, no, it's not really about making the most money, it's about achieving your artistic vision. Having said that, I don't want to imply that either Howard Roark or I would think it's wrong for people to be making lots of money. I think it's really fine. It's really great. It's just, well, the particular historical path that I took to accomplish my work took me in this nonprofit route. For me, it's a lot more, it's about volunteerism. In other words, that everyone who participates in Wikipedia does so of their own free will. If they don't want to do it, they don't do it, and that's fine. There's no compulsion involved, and that's really the moral principle that I think is far more important than for-profit versus non-profit.